Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the Endata Project at Easterseals Crossroads. And today we're going to be talking about voice control on the iPad. So let's take a look. So today we're going to take a look at voice control. Voice control is a new feature, accessibility feature found in iOS 13, the most recent update to the iOS operating system. And so on iPads, on your iPhone, any iOS device, they have now included something called voice control, which I'm super excited about because I have been working with Dragon, naturally speaking. It's something we've covered in our tech tips before and allows folks to be able to get hands-free access to the computer. Well, now with voice control on your iPad, now you have hands-free access to the iPad as well. The first thing I want to show you is where it is. So if you go into your menu, your settings menu, you're going to find something that's also new with iOS 13 in the fact that the accessibility settings have been given a prominent place within the overall settings of the device. And so over here on the main screen, you used to have to dig down a little bit to be able to find the accessibility settings. It used to be under general. Well, now it's just out here with everything else. And when I click on it, it brings me to the overall menu of the different things that it has for accessibility. And I'm really, again, very excited about some of the things they've added. Specifically, today, talking about voice control, you'll find under physical and motor voice control. And if I click that open, the first thing you want to do is make sure that it's turned on. And I've gone ahead and turned it on. And then I'm just going to start to talk to my computer and notice that I'm not touching the screen at all. I'm just using my voice to navigate and to enter text. And so here we go. Wake up. Go home. Swipe left. Swipe right. Go to sleep. And I want to mention something. I don't know if you could see that on the camera, but every icon that's on my iPad receives a number now. And you can turn that on or off depending on how comfortable you are with being able to use your voice to control the iPad. But the nice thing about those numbers is then you can just say the number that's associated with the icon that you want to open up. And so not only icons, but buttons, anything that's clickable within an application will get a number. And you can just say those numbers to be able to navigate to the next piece. And so let's do this again. Wake up. 22. 7. Hello, comma. My name is Brian Norton, period. New paragraph. How are you doing today? Question mark. Go home. Go to sleep. And so there you got just a little bit of a taste of it, of what voice control can do. So not only, again, navigating the screen, but also being able to dictate text, select text, those kinds of things within your document or whatever you're writing. Just something to take a look at if you haven't looked at it already. Definitely do. It's pretty amazing at what it can do. It's really easy to get up and going with it. And again, it's on all of your iOS devices. And I'll also mention on your Mac, on the Mac operating system, they've also included some additional voice control. Because on the Mac, you used to be able to dictate pretty well, but now they've provided some options for you to be able to control your Mac as well with voice. And so it's really kind of opened up some doors. I look for continued development in this area to, again, increase people's access to iOS devices and making it really a hands-free environment for folks. So that's your tech tip for this week. My name is Brian Norton with the Endata Project at Easterseals Crossroads.